This is the first video that I will be transliterating.
Okay, so let's get started, class, and I have a question for you. If you wrote the longest sentence possible that you could ever write, how long do you think it would be? How many words?
283,000.
Now, it has to be grammatically correct also. It can't be wrong. 25 words?
100
words. And it be grammatically correct? Do you think you can do that? Mm-hmm. That's cool. Okay. How many words do you think this is? No, don't count. Micah.
239.
You saw it on here. Yes, this is 239 words. And this is one sentence that is completely correct. Y'all know how to write a sentence that's correct and it'd be this long? That is exactly right. And what is a conjunction? Fanboys? Okay, let's say them together.
For and or but or
yet. So, good job. And tell me again what those words are.
Fanboys.
Fanboys, and what are conjunctions? And what do conjunctions do?
They separate the sentence.
Yeah, they join a sentence together, right? Okay, so I need a couple of helpers up here, please.
Oh, everyone, yes.
Marlene, and yes. Okay. We are going to tackle a challenge together, class.
I'm on one side of it. Okay. I'm going to let you know the other
side. Can I hold the middle?
Yes, someone can come out the middle. Okay, and I need one brave soul who thinks that they can, let me finish first, who thinks that they can read this entire sentence strip without pausing like a period. Think you can do it? Come on. I think you can do it.
I know I can.
It was a spectacular, beautiful day. There was not a cloud in the sky, and the sun was shining. George and Pam went to the park to have a picnic.
Keep going.
To have a picnic, they had pickles and peanut butter sandwiches and sparkling water while sitting on a red and white blanket. George tossed a frisbee to the dog and ran to the other park to go with goers who passed their daylight little picnic.
Okay, what is wrong with this sentence?
Yeah.
Or what's something else? Instead of conjunctions, what's something else you could do? Could you break it apart and do like different sentences?
Yes.
So what is this sentence called with like just how it is?
A run-on.
Yes, a run-on sentence. Have y'all talked about run-on sentences?
We just started.
Okay. Well. So do y'all think we can fix this sentence together?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. Zachary, you want to come up and do the first one? We're going to break it into different sentences. We're not going to use conjunctions today because y'all worked a lot for that. We're going to break it into smaller sentences today. So to break it into a smaller sentence, what would we have to use?
Period
and
a sentence.
Semicolon. Well, have a little letter.
Yes.
Very simple. Okay, so Zachary's going to do the first one for us.
It was a spectacularly beautiful day. There was not a cloud in the sky. The sun was shining.
You want to help him out? Where do you think we should stop at first?
Right here.
write on sentence? Can we break it down smaller?
Yes.
How do you think we can break it down in smaller?
It was a spectacular, beautiful day.
Period. I think so too. I like that. Because that's a good, meaty sentence right there. So it was a spectacularly beautiful day. Period. And capital. So what's the next sentence? You want to do it, Marlene?
There was no clouds on the sky.
Yes. Okay, so next sentence.
So you have to have a comma after and.
Can you help me out?
Yeah.
Yes. We're starting at George now.
George and Dan went to the park, so I would take.
Let's stop it there.
Yes.
Okay. Okay, so we have, it was a spectacularly beautiful day, period. There was not a cloud in the sky, and the sun was shining. Period. Okay. George and Pam. Wait, you stopped here, didn't you? Okay. So, you want to do this one?
George and Pam went to the park.
George and Pam went to the park to. Micah, you want to come help us with this one? Stop it there. Okay, well, let's keep looking at it. George and Pam went to the park to have a picnic. They had pickles and peanut butter sandwiches with sparkling water. After water. Zachary, you ready for another one?
What about Michael? Like water. While sitting on a bed in his white blanket, George tossed a frisbee to the dog and waved to the other park goers who had the light bulb and little kitten.
So that was a long sentence. Was that, do y'all think that was a good sentence?
Yes, no.
No,
Micah, you think we can break it up somewhere else?
There's two ends. For sure.
So you know, I read him off. George tossed a frisbee to the dog and went to the other park goer. She passed him a lot to look at me. Good job. Great. Okay, so y'all tackled that. You're very good. Okay, let's put this over here. And now that y'all know how to work with run-on sentences, we're going to have a little relay race. Okay? Y'all want to break up into groups of four?
No.
Or do you want me to break you up?
Yeah.
Do that? This side? Sound good? Okay. Let's set our chairs in a line. Let's do two different lines, okay? Okay, this is a run-on sentence relay, and I have eight sentences, so that means that each of you will get to do two sentences. And y'all know that in a relay, you pass things back, right? Is that usually how it works? Okay, so there's eight sentences, first people in the line, Marlene and Zachary. Y'all will do the first one. You're going to correct the run-on sentence. Do I have pencils with you?
No. And we can pass out the pencils back. No, we all can. Can't we?
And that is the end of the first video.